order for us to apply the knowledge that we have acquired from the two-dimensional concept up to the 3D-dimensional concepts, join us in doing this exercise to enhance our skills. There are a lot of ways or methods that you can choose in plotting your 2D and 3D drafts. It is important to note that each method comes with a different flow in your drafting experience, meaning it may direct you towards an easier method, or it may direct you towards a more complex method. It may also direct you towards a faster and more efficient path, or it may direct you towards a time-consuming path. It depends on your methods, which is why it is significantly important to thoroughly analyze what you are plotting and have knowledge on the element, especially on the basics of AutoCAD. Before we begin doing this exercise, let's make sure to turn on all our modes in the 3D OSNAP in order for us to have a smoother flow and an easier drafting experience. That is done. Now let's dive in. In this 3D exercise, we will slowly begin plotting by starting at the most bottom part of the object. This method, I believe, enables me to draft this exercise in an easier and a spontaneous manner. In the most bottom part, we can see the circular base, which measures 40 millimeters in diameter. Let's use the circle command, specifically the center diameter circle. Specify the diameter, which is 40 millimeters, and done. Notice that it has a height of 2 millimeters, so what we are going to do in order to solidify that height is to utilize the press pull command. Click press pull, click the plane you want to pull, and specify the distance, which is 2 millimeters. Make sure that when you are using the press pull command, you must direct your cursor towards the direction you want the object to be pulled. Next, let's plot the second layer, which is this one. In order to stack your object, especially in stacking this circular 2D object to this previous object that you have plotted, let's make sure to change our view into the 2D wireframe view in order for us to perceive all the lines that have been made. Notice that the previous object that you have press pulled has two centers. The explanation to this is that as you press pull that specific 2D object to make it a 3D object, you are actually creating another 2D circle as we can see here. One at the top and one at the bottom. This is important to know, especially in this part wherein we would need to stack objects in order for us to attain the most appropriate locations of the objects. Going back to the second layer, utilize the same command, which is the center diameter circle. Specify the diameter, which is 34 millimeters. And done. Now let's begin stacking this 2D object to the 3D. Command move for your 2D object. Specify the base point, which is the center, and make sure to click the uppermost center of the 3D object, since we are stacking our object. If we click the bottom center of the 3D object, it would cause your 2D object to be somehow buried as you press pull it later. Now that the stacking is done, press pull this newly stacked 2D object to make it a 3D. Click press pull, direct your cursor upward, and specify the height, which is 3 millimeters. Done. We have plotted up to this part of the object. so far, we are still disregarding these hollow parts. Just sit on tight and we will get into that later. For now, let's focus on the main body, which is these hatched parts. The next layer that we'll be plotting is this layer. Notice that it also has a diameter and a height. This means that the same method will be applied just like the previous objects. So, let's do that. Now that we have added layers from the bottom up to this part, let's begin by plotting the hollow parts. First hollow that we're going to plot is this one, which has a diameter of 26 millimeters. So what is this 26 millimeter hollow? As we can observe in this isometric image, the 26 diameter hollow is actually this one here. So in order to achieve that perfect hollow, here's a technique to do that. Notice in this image, the 26mm hollow is actually elevated 7mm from the most bottom part of the object. What we're going to do is plot a 26mm diameter circle in the most bottom part of the object. Once we have done that, move the object upwards or elevate the object by using the move command by 7mm. After doing that, click press pull and pull the 26mm diameter upward with a distance of 2.5mm. Which is indicated in the dimensions of the exercise. In the inner part of the object, we would have to remove that 26mm diameter object in order to attain a hollow design. To do that, we can utilize the subtract command. The subtract command is somehow simply similar to the mathematical subtraction concept, which is to subtract an object from another object. This means that we would have to subtract this 26mm diameter object from the main body, which is this whole object. So, click Subtract, select the main body, which is the minuend object, and click Enter. And finally, select the subtractor, which is the 26mm diameter object. Then, hit Enter. Done! We can't actually see it from the outside, but if we are going to slice this object in half, we can definitely see that the 26mm diameter object was removed from the main body, which explains the hollow part. Now that we have achieved the designs from the bottom up to this part, we will then proceed to the upper portions of the object. By the way, we disregarded this part since this part can be plotted simultaneously with the upper portions, and we are going to delve into that later. To plot these upper portions, this image here is your guideline. First, we would create the 2D top view of this object and stack it later to the most upper part of the already created 3D object. So, let's begin! In this top view, we will first plot the most outer part of the object, in which we already know is a 62mm diameter circle. Notice that its arc length is 120 degrees, meaning the circle is divided into three sections, since 360 degrees divided by 3 is 120 degrees. So, let's divide this object by 3 and connect the lines for our guide. Notice in the image that one section of this part of the object is located at the top. So we would want to rotate our object until this part is placed at the top. Notice the 20mm and 10mm distances. They are somehow divided in half. So analyzing that information, it is understandable that the offset distance of each line is 5mm including the guidelines. Let's utilize the offset command to achieve this. After offsetting all the required lines, plot the 20mm diameter circle and then thoroughly trim all the unnecessary lines. For the next part, as what I've said earlier about this one, we are going to make that simultaneously with this top view. So, how did we accurately place these circles? This is where the 50mm diameter circle and the 15 degree angled lines come in. We would need the intersections between this circle and these lines in order to accurately place these three circles. For that, we would need the intersection O-snap, which we already turned on before we began this exercise. So, let's plot the circle in line guides, and then plot the three circles with diameters of 9.5 and 5.5 millimeters. After plotting the important parts, thoroughly trim the unnecessary lines and guidelines. We have created the upper portion design. All that's left to do now is to utilize the 3D commands. Based on the image, if we press pull these three sections, the height would be 19mm. So, click press pull, click an object, select multiple, select the other sections, click enter, specify the press pull distance, and then hit enter again. For the next part, if we view it in this perspective, there are holes in each of the sections. Notice that the distance from the center of the circles up to the edges, either vertically and horizontally, are the same. In a vertical perspective, we can see here that the total height of the object, which is 32 millimeters, and the total height from the bottom to the center of the circle, which is 24 millimeters. Using this information, we would only need to subtract 24 from 32 to attain this distance. The distance from the edges up to the center of the circle would then be 8 millimeters. To attain these hollow circles, here's a technique. However, you can use other methods as you see fit, but for me, this is convenient. First, construct a cylinder with a diameter of 6 millimeters from the endpoint of each edge. Rotate the cylinder and connect it to the other endpoint to achieve the appropriate angle. Move the cylinder inwards using the move command with the distance attained, which is 8 millimeters. And move it downwards with the same distance, which is also 8 millimeters. Make sure that the base point is the center of the cylinder. Now do the same processes with the other two sections. After creating the cylinders, let us use the subtract command in order to attain the hollow designs. Click subtract, select these three sections which are the menu end, then hit enter, and then select all the cylinders which are the subtractors, then hit enter. Voila! We're almost done! All we need to do now is to obtain the hollow designs from these three circles and then chamfer these edges, and then we are done. So, to chamfer these edges spontaneously, command chamfer, select line, specify the distance, which is 4 millimeters, hit enter, select the edge you want to chamfer, then hit enter again. Done! Now do the same for the other edges. For the final piece of the solid work, let us attain the appropriate hollow design and press-pull distance of these three circles. First, as we can see in the reference image, we would need the circular diameter of 5.5 to be hollow until the bottom of the object. So click press-pull, select an object, select multiple, select all the 5.5 diameter circles, and then pull it downwards to remove it. For the circles with 9.5 millimeter diameters, based on the reference image, we would need to press pull these circles downward with a distance of 4.6 millimeters. So, do the same process and specify the distance. And we are done! Oh wait, we forgot the middle part. This is also a hollow section, and all we need to do is press pull this object downward until it is removed. Finally, we are done. Behold, our finished product for today's 3D exercise. Thanks for joining me on this AutoCAD tutorial journey. I sincerely hope you found the tips and knowledge offered to be useful. For more AutoCAD content, don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell. Keep exploring and expanding your creative boundaries. Comment below with your thoughts and ideas for future videos. Keep developing your AutoCAD skills because practice makes perfect. For more information and resources, keep up your social media connections. Happy drafting until next time. Thanks for watching and keep designing.